Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
In this video, I want to talk to you about what to do when you see you have a bill and an expense, and the expense is for exactly the same dollar amount as the bill. You're looking at this and you know what happened. A bill got entered and then a payment was made, but somehow it just wasn't made correctly in QuickBooks and things are a little bit askew. So I'll start with the end and show you how to fix it. And then I'll go backwards and just show you how you identify that things are askew. To fix this, you just want to click on the expense, open it up and say QuickBooks. That is not what I wanted from you. You can see I wear glasses. I bad vision. If you look very closely, even with bad vision like mine, you will see the smallest, faintest arrow in the upper right-hand corner. When you click on this arrow, you're going to have this option to add something to your expense. The thing you want to add to your expense is the bill. I know it sounds silly, but if you add the bill to the expense, QuickBooks will convert it to a bill payment. So I'm going to click on the word add. When you connect the bill, the upper left-hand corner, the bold text changes from expense to bill payment. The bill is selected here. This expense down here, this is just here to throw you off. What I would recommend doing is just verifying that this is the correct bank account where the money came from, and this is the correct dollar amount, and then just select save and close. Once this is done, you can take just a moment, look at your QuickBooks, and make sure nothing feels silly. There's a bill payment. That expense we saw a moment ago, it's disappeared. It's not there anymore. That's perfect. That means that you don't have to do anything extra. From here, if you need more peace of mind, you can look at the register, you know, check register, credit card register, wherever that money was spent, and you'll see there'll only be one entry of $12. Let me take a moment and put it back to the way it was so that I can show you what it looks like, how you can identify that there's an error. Okay, so this is what we had before. The ways that you can tell on the vendor screen that you have a problem is that it says there's $12 overdue, but the open balance, meaning the total amount of money you owe to Dropbox, is $0. The reason you have an overdue is because there's a bill that's open that's not paid. The reason that it shows that you owe Dropbox zero money is because QuickBooks is smart enough to add together all the credits and all the bills and say, okay, you don't owe any money. But the big takeaway here is that the bill is not marked paid. In order to solve this, you need the bill to be marked paid. I'll show you a different way to do that in just a second. Let me go to Accounts Payable. You might notice a problem when you look at Accounts Payable and you see $0. Why would this even show up if it's $0? I've got 500 vendors. Why is QuickBooks picking one of them? QuickBooks is picking one to display because there's something happening behind the scenes. When you click on the $0, you get a list of what's happening. And you can look at this and say, oh, these two things need to be connected. Right now, what I've got is I have a bill and a expense. In the beginning of the video, I showed you a way to fix it. Let me show you one more way. If I go to the bill and I say mark as paid, I can connect the bill with the credit, which is really that expense that got recorded. Once I do this, do a bill payment or mark the bill as paid, and I say save and close, it's going to mark the bill as paid, and it's going to create one more record in that vendor profile or in the list of vendor transactions. So now you've got the bill, the expense, and the bill payment check. It's fine, but if I'm the one doing the bookkeeping, I'm going to fix this expense and you're not going to see three lines. You're just going to see two, like I showed you at the beginning of the video. So I hope this is helpful. I know it's the sort of thing that probably won't come up for very many people, but if this comes up for you, I really hope this helps you. If you have any questions, if you need custom help, if you want to show me the thing, have me walk you through it, you're totally welcome to do that. You can book time with me on gentlefrog.com. Okay, thanks.